Here in this illustration, we'll study about the curvature radius of trajectory of a projectile motion. Here we are given that a particle is projected from ground with initial speed u and projection angle theta from horizontal. And we are required to find the radius of curvature of trajectory of particle when during flight, particle's velocity makes an angle theta by 2 with the horizontal. Here, if we just have a look on the situation from ground when a particle is projected with the initial speed u at an angle theta, it follows the projectile trajectory and at some point in its flight, if its speed is v, it is making an angle theta by 2 with the horizontal. Say this point is P and the starting point was A. Then we can write during flight, we can write the horizontal component of velocity and does not change. So we can write u cos theta is equals to v cos theta by 2. So this will give us the speed of projectile at point P, which is u cos theta by cos of theta by 2. If we need, we can use the speed in terms of initial speed of projectile here. And now, if we wish to calculate the curvature radius of trajectory at point P, then the direct relation we have, the radius of curvature for any trajectory is given as 1 plus dy by dx whole square 2 power 3 by 2 divided by d square y by dx square magnitude. And at this point P, we can write the slope of at point P, the slope of trajectory can be given as dy by dx, which is equals to tan theta by 2. And if we calculate the second derivative, then the equation of trajectory will give us second derivative, as we can write. Equation of trajectory is y is equals to x tan theta minus gx square by 2u square cos square theta. So from here we can get the value of d square y by dx square, which is minus g by u square cos square theta. You can simply differentiate it twice with respect to x. Now from this relation we can see the radius of curvature at a point where a slope is tan theta by 2, we can write it as 1 plus tan square theta by 2 to power 3 by 2 divided by the value of second derivative magnitude, this g by u square cos square theta. On further simplifying, we are getting the result as u square by g cos square theta multiplied by sec cube theta by 2. This is the final result of this problem. One more way in which the problem can be solved by using the normal acceleration of particle. Like here, if we handle it in an alternative way, to solve the same problem, here you can see if the particle is moving in the trajectory, it is experiencing g in downward direction, and when its velocity is making an angle theta by 2, the direction of normal is also at an angle theta by 2 with respect to vertical. Now in this situation, g has two components. One is g cos theta by 2, which will act as normal acceleration. Another is g sin theta by 2, which is acting as tangential acceleration on the particle if we resolve g in normal tangential coordinate system. So in this situation here, we can see the normal acceleration of a particle at P is An, we can write as g cos theta by 2. And normal acceleration we can write as v square by r. So here v square by r is g cos of theta by 2. and the speed we already calculated here, so this can be substituted and this will give us directly the radius of curvature, which is u square by g cos square theta by cos cube theta by 2, that is sec cube theta by 2, which is the same result we are getting, which we have calculated here.